that uses art by people who are incarcerated to bring public awareness to issues, critical issues in the criminal justice system. And this is the co-founder, right?
Somebody pushing a car.
part, we all play a role. This is our life and our culture, and how do we decide to play that role? Amazing painting. This is called Aspirations 1, to balance Aspirations 2. And this painting gets a lot of conversation, and Danny just put it together. He actually put together the life he knew as a child growing up in Philadelphia.
Mm-hmm.
I was here last week, and my young woman Jasmine said this was the painting that hit her the most, because she said this is what her community looks like every day, and yet we expect the children to go to school.
Mm-hmm.
So, profound piece. This piece is by George Lopez, whom I've been writing to since 1999. George is on death row at Green. And the way our friendship started, he had started something called the Death Row Comics with Richard Young, who was on death row. I would sit at Greaterford waiting to visit Charles Lawson and read Greater Friends. So Richard Young actually got off death row. That's a whole other story. And I met him in the visiting room at Greaterford, because I am not a volunteer. This is not a prison program.
Okay.
This is a private citizen initiative. That's why I can use names. Because I'm not a part of the criminal justice system. But back to the story. So I met Richard Young in the visitor room at Greaterford, and I said to him, if you know somebody on death row who has no family, no friend, I will write to him. I didn't say he has to be innocent. I find the death penalty repugnant and a severe abuse of human rights.
Mm-hmm.
So I started to write to George, and he was soon on a 30-day countdown to execution. I have boxes of letters from George. I have hundreds of cartoons from George. He is just an amazing person in terms of the way he can communicate. He did this for exhibit we had at St. Asaph's. And again, whether he's innocent or not is not, you know, I'm not an attorney. I use art to bring public awareness to the issues.
So are you an artist?
I actually am a poet and dancer. I have my leotard on.
Okay.
And I teach dance and yoga. I'm a social justice activist, and I did get the Leeway Transformation Award as a woman artist who's worked for social change. I got that in 2008 for poetry and for photography.
Okay. And when did you start Art for Justice?
I bought the first painting from Charles Lawson in 1995 at a local art show.
Mm-hmm.
It was in my community, and I wrote to thank him. We became friends. The first time I shared one of his artworks was 1997. His wife and I took the artwork to the Quakers annual meeting, and I became friends with him and with his family. Unfortunately, he's not married anymore. So I've been his friend through a lot of struggles and a lot of sorrow. And there's some fabulous art that's come out of this.
That's awesome. It's awesome that you were there for him. It's even more awesome that you did it unjudgmentally. You just was there to help somebody and to bring awareness to a subject. I think that's really awesome.
I come from a family of social justice advocates, or not advocate isn't the word, they lived it. My family founded Germantown, Jan Lucan, Mary Lucan, Rainier Tyson, first anti-slavery proclamation. After that, the family became active in the Underground Railroad, Charles Kirk. I actually have his recollections, and I mean, it'll just knock your socks off. These people lived what they believed. Charles Kirk would get in his buggy and go down south in the 1830s. Trying to talk people out of slavery. A lot of people don't know that many Quakers in Montgomery County, where he lived, had slaves. Charles Kirk would not eat food at a neighbor's table if the food came from slave labor. So there was intense struggle in the Quaker community, and that's the side they were on. Another cousin, George Lukens, who lived at what is now Christopher Dock in Montgomery County, was active in the Underground Railroad. These are just legendary stories in the family, but they had allegedly dug a tunnel from the well, the well house, and it went out into a far field. And the rumor heard, what was passed down, is that no one was ever caught. Montgomery County is an area steeped in stories of the Underground Railroad. It goes right up through Allentown Road.
I know some places here in Philadelphia that's Underground Railroad, but a lot of people don't know about them.